What's up, everybody? Dude, right back at it again with another video. Today we're going to be talking about something that I've just been seeing going out a lot, and I'm not really sure why, but it seems like there are talks about Insurgency Sandstorm going free to play on console. Now, I just want to be clear, I don't think this is coming from a developer's perspective. I think it's just coming from a bunch of YouTubers trying to make an argument for console's sake to go free to play. I don't believe it's the developers themselves saying that they want to do that. I just think it's YouTubers who are saying that they would think that it's a good idea for them to go free to play on console. So I believe this actually started with North Cinematics. He's another YouTuber that I've seen around, but I don't think I really, you know, talked to or talked about really that much. So he starts off the conversation with trying to improve relationships between the developers and console players, which makes sense because they've delayed the game so much for a console that you'd think they'd give them some sort of, you know, perk or an update. Like, basically, there's a lot of console players that really want this game, or any tactical game that I play, really, on the console. But they've just had really bad luck of trying to get those types of games. And with Insurgency especially, there has been like a very lack of transparency when it comes to the release date of Insurgency on the console. And I think the thing that really scares me is that they could cancel it, which they have done in the past, especially when it comes to like the single player story mode. But I mean, I highly doubt that they're gonna cancel the console release, because that's just a giant market right there for them. Like, I think they'd have to be giant idiots to pass up on that market, but I'm just not ruling it out, you know. But yeah, anyways, North Cinematics' main argument is because of the lack of transparency and delays, the developers at NWI should cut console players some slack by making the game go free to play. He states that there's already microtransactions, so what's the issue? But I think one of the crux of his arguments is that he says that the game is going to be $60. Well, on PC, it's only $30. I don't know if it's ever been confirmed how much it's actually going to be on console. I was looking around and I didn't see anything pertaining to the actual price on console. According to a lot of the people that are in my Discord that are really close to the developers, it's said that it's expected to be around $30 to $40 US, which is pretty much the same price as what we're getting right now. So yeah, I'm not really sure if that argument really holds up, but I think the whole cut console players some slack is kind of like not a great argument either, because they didn't cut us any slack. Like, they kind of gave us like a game that was like really unoptimized and broken, and for the longest time there was a huge drought of content. Like, I mean, I really like the developers, but they do make a lot of boneheaded decisions if you ask me. Like, my biggest thing with the game is that there wasn't a whole lot of content. Like, I was actually really pissed off when they weren't doing a whole lot of content, and when they did content, it was stuff that I felt that it should have been in the game day one, you know? Like, if they had actually just delayed the game like a whole 2 years, then I feel like this stuff should have been in the game already. Like, the whole night maps with flashlights and NVGs and a bunch of rehashed or revamped maps from Insurgency 2014 touted as new content, and they had the gall to add microtransactions. Just the lack of content that's not like rehashed or, you know, should have been day one. I mean, I'm kind of going off on a tangent right here. I have like multiple videos where I talk about this sort of thing, so I'm gonna try to restrain myself because I'm going a bit off topic here. But I just want to mention that this game still has a lot of issues, and I'm not talking about content wise. There's this guy named Sick Snipes, I think that's how you say his name. He made a video called Operation Cold Blood Isn't What We Need, and he goes over the issues that are plaguing the game as it stands now. So where I have an issue with content, he has an issue with the game itself at the moment. I highly suggest you go check out this video, because it actually gives you a perspective that I didn't even know that there was. That link will be down in the description along with all the other videos that I am currently talking about. So now I'm going to get into the reason as to why I actually made this video. I saw a video from Abel Green, who was actually talking about North Cinematic's video, and I think I agree more with him than I do with North Cinematic, because he's coming from a business perspective. His main argument is, while it would be nice for Insurgency Sandstorm to actually make up with the console community, he just thinks that it won't work, because while they do have microtransactions, they can't guarantee that anybody who downloads the game will actually keep going for those microtransactions. So why not have the best of both worlds? They got the guaranteed 30, and and also the microtransactions afterwards, which if I know console players, they tend to go for microtransactions almost all the goddamn time, if Madden is any indication.
Also, it wouldn't really be fair to people on PC if console players got free to play and we had to pay for it, especially when we're kind of like going through all the freaking nonsense of dealing with the broken and unoptimized game in the beginning with a content drought. I would be livid. Just saying.
I really hope they don't go that route. But yeah, I think I'm gonna end the video here. What are your thoughts? Do you think the developers of New World Interactive should cut some slack for the console players, or do you think otherwise? Should it go free to play, or should it get the same price as everybody else? Oh, that's all I really got to say. If you enjoy the fact that I cover games like Insurgency Sandstorm or anything that's really going on around it, like the video, share the video, and comment down below. If you're someone that would like to support the channel, check out my Patreon. Just send $2 a month. It really helps. If you're someone that's new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and ding the bell. You never know, you might find something that you like on the channel. And with that all being said, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.